We are going to make our service unkillable in every aspect. Automatically start up, run in foreground, and many other things. But you must have a reason to run your, to make your service unkillable. For example, these two apps, internet speed meter and daily usage time collects data 24/7. Another example could be a pedometer, which collects data about how much steps you take, no matter your phone is sleeping or not. But if you are trying to make an unkillable service only for checking a condition, it is better to use a job scheduler or intent or broadcast receiver. Service could be a bad idea for that kind of work. Before you start working on your project, I would recommend you to watch this video from last 8th minute to 10th minute, 2 minutes. Watch them at a startup, it will save you a lot of your time. Creating a never-ending background service. Oh, sorry, that's not background service, it is foreground service, because it will show a notification. Our never-ending service is a combination of job scheduler, notification, broadcast receiver, and obviously a service. First of all, let's create a project. Add a onResume event inside it. Go to link provided in description. Copy that code and put it in ASD. So here, if our build version is Lollipop or greater, we are scheduling a job, else we are directly starting a service, because job scheduler is not supported on older operating systems. Now let's compile our project once, so it generates Java code. We can fetch it using XML editor pro. So here we can see problems, restart service broadcast receiver and process main class cannot be resolved because we don't have created them yet. We will go to XML editor pro, fetch our code, and again link provided in description. We will add permissions by copy and paste. Broadcast receiver and service to our manifest. Here we are listening to two important actions. One is boot completed, so our service automatically starts when phone boot is completed. Second is our custom intent, so we are launching when we start our application, then our service will be started. Once we have done this, save manifest by clicking here. Now it's time to create our classes. Our first class is globals, in which we will keep our constant values. After pasting the code, remove duplicate package name if you have any. Then we will create job service class, which is our job scheduler. Make sure you have correct file names. After job scheduler, we will create a notification. Customize import statements as per your package name. We have a bunch of import statements from our created classes, so we have to modify all these import statements. After notification, we have process main class. Copy it, create a new class, paste the code. After that, we have restart service broadcast receiver. That is the class which does actual magic. Whenever our service ends, it will restart it. Be careful while typing class names. You have to type them correctly. Don't make any typo mistake. Then, most important class, the service itself. Copy paste work is done for now. Now start injecting code. Get back to sketchware. Turn on app compat and design library and compile the app. So we have an error here, invalid character. I don't know where did it came from, but I have tried really hard a lot of times, but I can't eliminate that. So I have a solution. I have backup classes in a zip file. I will extract it and add them. You can download them from link in description. Delete previously added classes and start adding them. Must rename package name at the top to your package name. What I have done was that instead of changing package name and modifying all import statements, I have changed package name in my app. Let's try to compile the app now. Now we have to add an icon and name it IC Sleep. Finally, our app is ready. Compile it and see the result. In your notifications class, change notification channel and notification ID. If you all guys are going to use same notification ID and same notification channel, if user blocked any one developer's apps, any other developer using same notification channel will be automatically notifications blocked. So everybody make sure you use your own notification ID and channel.